Hi, I'm in the sun, I see. I better turn this way. Hopefully I'm not sitting in a puddle of water. I just wanted to share something really quick with you. I know I never do anything really quick, but a lot of people have been asking me this question. And so I want to answer it. Hopefully I have a weak signal again out here, but hopefully it's good enough that you can see me. You think as much money as we pay for our connection up here on the mountain that we would be getting a better signal. Anyway, I just wanted to share with you really quick how to hear from the Holy Spirit. So if the screen is fuzzy, at least you can hear my voice. The best way I describe hearing from the Holy Spirit is you have to trust the Holy Spirit is called our teacher and our guide, and you have to trust that you hear from the Holy Spirit. That small, still voice that you hear is not your own conscience, it's the Holy Spirit. And when you begin to practice hearing from the Holy Spirit, you will hear more from the Holy Spirit. So basically, the Word of God says that the more you focus on something as you believe in your heart, you are, and the more you you reap what you sow. So if you practice hearing from the Holy Spirit, then you'll hear more from the Holy Spirit. And I started by just saying, okay, I'm thinking of a scripture, but I don't know what verse it is. So Holy Spirit, show me what book of the Bible it's in. And then I would go to the first image or thought that came to my mind would be a book of the Bible. And I'd go there and I'd look. And so that's how I practice hearing from the Holy Spirit, by asking him whenever I thought of a particular scripture and didn't know where it was, instead of looking it up in the Strong's Concordance, I would say, Holy Spirit, what book is that? What chapter? What verse? And then I began to hear his voice and trust him more and more, that every time I heard him, that it would be him. And sometimes I miss it because, you know, we're not perfect. But practice hearing the Holy Spirit by asking him whenever you think of a verse or a scripture or something Jesus said or somebody said in the Word of God, ask the Holy Spirit, now you're my teacher and I'm going to trust that you're inside of me and teaching me, so where is that at? And don't use the concordance, and take your time and just keep, every time an image, a thought, a scripture, a number comes in your mind, write it down and go look. And then after a while, if you can't find it, look it up in the Strong's. And that way you build up your trust in hearing from the Holy Spirit. And it really gets a lot of fun doing that. And so that's my advice to the people that are saying, how do you know you hear from the Holy Spirit? How do you hear from the Holy Spirit? Well, the more you look at the Word of God, the more revelation pops out at you. I can take one sentence of the scripture and I can study on that one sentence for years and get revelation out of it. It is just so much fun. It's like a giant puzzle. An everyday interactive puzzle is what it's like having a relationship with Jesus. And so, to get revelation out of the Word, pick something that speaks to you. Like right now, in the past couple years, I've been on putting on the whole armor of God, and I've gotten awesome revelation on that. And I'd go for a walk and I'd pray in tongues and I just meditate on one word at a time in the scripture that talks about putting on the whole armor of God. And then God would put different scriptures together and I'd study on that. And I wrote several books on that and on the Lord's Prayer and stuff like that. And he would make it pop out and it would become alive to you. So what you focus on, you get more of. When I was studying about walking in the supernatural things of God, I would see more of what I was studying. When I was studying about the clouds and the angels, I would see clouds and everywhere I go, I see them. They are so cool and so fun. When I study on communion, everything that happens around my life, everything I see and hear relates to communion. So the more you focus on the Word, the more you trust that the Holy Spirit is your teacher. By the way, trust the Holy Spirit to speak to your kids, and that your kids hear the Holy Spirit, because they can hear the Holy Spirit. When you take away from them their imagination, you're taking away from them the connection to the spirit realm. And we are all spirits. out, and we have a body and we have a soul. And so don't take that imagination away from your kids. In fact, become like a little kid and have imagination. Trust that you're hearing from the Holy Spirit, no matter how silly it is. Begin to keep a journal. When you begin to keep a journal of the little things that the Holy Spirit has done for you, the little supernatural things, and you go back and you review them, it opens up the door, the window, the gate, whatever, for you to experience more. So when you write it down, you can experience more. It's a secret, sort of. The more you focus on something, you write down the events that happened in your life that, get out of here, B. Shoot, Jesus' name, go. That relate to the Holy Spirit, the more you'll have that. So that's just my little tidbit on how to hear from the Holy Spirit, how to get more out of the Word of God. The Word of God is love poems, love stories, love relationship with God. It reveals who God is. And we need the Word, but we also need the Holy Spirit, or He wouldn't have given it to us. So you have to trust the Holy Spirit. And of course, everything will balance with the Word, but not everything is written in the Word. And you just have to trust that you have a relationship with the Holy Spirit, and that you're hearing, and that your kids hear the Holy Spirit. So that's my suggestion, my advice. I hope it really helps you. And if you like this video, share it with your friends and your social media site. My website is robinbremer.net. If you're an author, I publish books for Christian authors. Check out my site and so on. If you want to write a guest post, that might be something available to you. Anyway, I do have to go to the store. I have been stuck out here for hours looking at the clouds and the hosts of heaven and taking pictures, because they were revealing themselves big time. And I had to get some pictures. I tried to take videos for you all, and I posted one, but in the middle of it, I stopped to take pictures. Okay, so have a blessed day. And remember, the Word of God says it's the grace of Jesus Christ. So walk in that grace, the communion of the Holy Spirit. Walk in that fellowship with the Holy Spirit and the love of God. And I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.